I think I'm killing Japanese. I really think so. It's Mitchell Page on today's Motivated Moments in History. Mitchell Page was born in Pennsylvania in 1918. As a kid, he became a Boy Scout and then graduated up to Eagle Scouts. You know, after high school, he traded in his merit badges for the Eagle, Globe, and Anchor of the United States Marine Corps. Once in the Corps, he was a gunner on the USS Wyoming as well as a member of the Marine Navy baseball team. You know, but when the attack on Pearl Harbor happened, he joined the 7th Marines and went overseas to go slay some motherfucking bodies! In October 1942, he was a platoon sergeant of a machine gun platoon in the Solomon Islands. The fighting there was fierce. So fierce that the U.S. even desired to retreat from the island, giving it to the Japanese. Well, due to consuming too much toxins from all those crayons they were eating, the Marines were unable to understand the word retreat and refused to do anything but kill some freaking Japs! As he was in his foxhole on the outer perimeter of the American line, his platoon noticed an advancement of roughly 2,500 enemy troops. He remained calm and waited for the first troops to get close enough that he could hear their footsteps. And when that happened, he jumped up and got his men jumped up and they sprayed bullets all over that some bitch like with some type of real freak show bukkake love fest like a freaking fire hose. They just shot everything. The Japs fought back and they fought back hard. And soon the entire place was swarming with bullets and blood mist. His attempts held the Japanese first assault back, but the second wave came at him. The enemy charged with bayonets and crossed into his position, resulting in the most epic Royal Rumble ever. You know, it was just filled with punching, stabbing, kicking the nuts, steel chairs, top rope jump, just sweet nasty. Oh my goodness, Ric Flair! Woo! Mitch was slashed so hard across his hand and so badly that he lost his grip strength severely. But that didn't stop him as he grabbed his K-bar and stabbed the guy in the freaking throat. He's like, you got a little something right here. You got it. It's called my K-bar. After the second wave was held, Mitch went to huddle his guys and try to motivate them and realign them. But there were no guys. They were all killed. He was all by himself. All by myself. I guess I gotta slay bodies. All by myself. So alone, he crept out a path through the Japanese formations and found a small group of Marines. He ordered those men to fix bayonets and follow him. They snuck back to the Japanese formation, this time from behind. Now with injuries and fatigue paired with the zero visibility of the night, they ran up on those Japs and Dragon Ball Z'd their asses by surprise. The Japs were terrified and disoriented. Once during the fight, a Japanese officer emptied his pistol at Mitchell, and when that didn't work, he charged at him with a freaking samurai sword. Well, you never take a knife to a gunfight. So Mitchell's like, Pikachu, I choose you, and spray that some bitch in half with a machine gun. Demoralized and defeated, the Japanese brigade called off their attack and retreated. After nearly 10 hours of bulk-crushing firefighting, Mitchell Page still held his position. For these heroics, he was awarded the Medal of Honor. Soon after the battle, he was transferred to Australia. He ended up making it to full bird and retired in 1959. He spent the rest of his years writing his autobiography and hunting down those stolen valor sons of bastards who were falsely claiming to be Medal of Honor recipients. He died in 2003 of congestive heart failure and was the last surviving Guadalcanal Medal of Honor recipient. He is buried in Riverside, California. And that, kids, is your Motivated Moments in History!